Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's we're going to be reviewing the Toyota GR Corolla. Before we get into this video though, as always, if you're going to save time and money the next time you purchase a car, link to my car buying guide in the description down below. Let's get into it. Under the hood, we have a turbocharged 1.6 liter 3-cylinder that goes through a 6-speed manual transmission. Power outputs are 300 horsepower and then 273 pound-feet of torque. Before we move forward with this review, I do want to mention, if you want to see more videos just like this, then I recommend you subscribe because I post content every single day. So starting with the hood, this red paint job looks pretty sweet if you ask me. And then I love the Corolla's new headlight design, super sharp. And then you can see with the fog light here, and then you've got the super aggressive grille with the GR version. And so it just looks like a Corolla that eats other Corollas for breakfast. Now around the side here, our turn wheel setup is 235, 40, 18 in the front and over in the rear. You can see the wheels completely blacked out. Got the red brake caliper. And by the way, this does have winter tires on it, so that is going to slightly affect performance in our video today, but we still have snow here, so if you're wondering. Anyways, GR badge. We got the venting there on the side. You can see here with the mirror cap also blacked out. And here's the side profile on the GR. This is where you can kind of see the wide body appearance in the front and in the rear. Now I've got a pretty normal Toyota key fob lock and unlock, Toyota logo, GR logo there on the back. And speaking of the back, you guys can see storage space against the Corolla. It's not massive, but the hatchback does help out quite a bit in terms of vertical room. And it's really easy to close that. Love the taillight design here. See GR Corolla. Of course, got the triple exhaust tips, one exhaust tip per cylinder. So finishing things up, let me know what you guys think about the looks. Now inside you've got cloth trim here on the door panel, a little bit of storage, and then same thing with the seats, cloth trim all down the center. And then legroom back here is solid, got a little driveline hump there in the center though. And then headroom, it's decent. Now taking a look at the front door panel again, you can see with this trim, we've got all of our window controls, mirror adjustment, and then let's quick look at the mirrors themselves, do have blind spot monitoring. And then here's the front seat, GR on it. And you can see again with the bucket type design, all of our adjustments there on the side of the seat, they are manual. I love the pedals, really nice finish on those. Now taking a look at the steering wheel, soft touch all around. We've got practical stuff like our adaptive cruise control, lane centering, we've got your volume and voice command controls, of course little GR logo there at the bottom, and then you have your regular stocks on the back. Digital gauge cluster in the center, and it's pretty cool with the drive modes here, you can see the center, and then this is where you can also adjust the traction control, so I just put it into track mode. You can see that right there as well. So yeah, just cool little setup. Just a regular backup camera in reverse, trajectory lines actually don't turn with the steering wheel, interestingly enough. And then as for the rest of the infotainment system, response time is pretty solid. It's Toyota's unit they have in all their cars, just kind of miniaturized here in the GR, has volume control. Got nice soft touch trim across the dash and down below as well with the stitching. Single zone climate, wireless phone charging pad, a little droid mode select here with your stability control. Shifter for that manual transmission, right, the GR logo there at the top. Driveline stuff right here, you can pop it all the way to the, well, it's a 30 in the front, 70% in the rear, but basically rear bias mode, some cup holders, big old park and brake, of course. No center console, just kind of like a little storage thing. But we do have a glove box, which is nice. And then no center for anything. And then here's our window sticker for this GR Corolla. This is a core, so this is kind of like your base model. But this does have the limited slips, which is what I recommend getting because it's only 1100 bucks. So just make sure you order that. Anyways, $39,659 is the MSRP. Let's see how it drives. Well, setting off in the GR Corolla. So this has been a demo vehicle for the week, and it's been a pretty fun demo vehicle for the week. I got a bit to say about GR Corolla when it comes to actually living with the car. So first off, this is a smaller car in terms of the dimensions and the wheelbase and all that. So it does have a little bit of a bumpier ride. It's not bad. It is not bad at all. It's just something to consider with the car when it comes to daily driving comfort. Now, something that is cool for the daily drive is the IMT, so it's the auto rev match function. And it makes it so you don't have to heel toe yourself. The car will basically do the blipping of the throttle for you, and avoid excessive acceleration due to temperature. So I guess we got to warm the car up even a little bit more. But anyways, it's pretty good. That was pulled back a little bit because everything's still warming up. But even then, it's solid. And you know, going quicker speeds, wind buffeting is not bad. It's a good daily driver car, and I think that's where this core comes in. And it's probably why Toyota sent out a core, is this is the GR Corolla that most people are gonna buy, because with limited slips and everything, it still is an amazingly fun car to drive, but it's more affordable. It's not, you know, the $45,000 to $50,000 price tag of the more loaded up GR Corollas. And my opinion on those is I think they're worth getting if you're gonna keep the car for a really long time. But if you're just getting this as like, I want a fun daily driver, this is the one to get, because it's more affordable, and the benefits of the, you know, I don't know, the circuit edition, for example, it feels like that's more of an aesthetic thing long term, like, hey, this is the collector Corolla, GR Corolla that I got. But yeah, look at that. It's perfect with the throttle blipping. I know some people say it's cheating, but hey, anything to make it so it's easier for millennials and Gen Z to drive manuals so that we can keep manuals. I'm all about that. And I'm saying that as someone who is Gen Z, of course, but so smooth. Love the turbo noise, just whoosh. It's such a nice sound. And again, it's a smooth power band. It really is a nice drive. I think they've done just a great job with the GR Corolla when it comes to the overall drive and performance. So I'm waiting to go up here so we can get a little bit more driving. I guess we'll see how it does with the train tracks here. And I will say, it's such a small car, and so 300 horsepower goes a long way in this car. It just always feels like there's power. It always feels like there's get up and go. Which is also surprising because it's a 3-cylinder. Yeah, it's so slick, that auto rev match. And yeah, the first gear in this car actually pulls pretty hard. Just look at the boost buildup. It's just, it's slick. So anyways, let me know what you guys think about the GR Corolla. I think in terms of hot hatches, I mean, the Subaru WRX is technically more affordable than this, but all-wheel drive, 300 horsepower, I don't think you can really beat it when you get one of these core packages. It's, I wouldn't say it's the value of the century, but it's a pretty solid offering overall. And again, look at the handling on this. It's pretty slick. Let me know what you guys think about the GR Corolla.